So this is a national mouse. I know at least two of my viewers are going to get mad because I am not going in. But I wanted you guys to take a quick look at the outside of national mouse. All right, cool. So you can actually see all of this stuff in the same area. I'll go to the KL Bird Park tomorrow morning, but a perfect day would be the KL Bird Park, the Islamic Arts Museum, and then the National Mosque. You spend maybe 2 hours each. So that's about 6 hours of your day knocked out. I wouldn't even say you need 2 hours at the National Mosque, maybe an hour at the National Mosque. So this whole area and everything is like within maybe 10 minutes of walking distance of each other. So it's pretty easy. You getting some drink? Is this mojito? What is it? What is that? Mint juice? Lemon mint?
Lime mint
juice. And watermelon. Y'all, you know you want watermelon, Kelly. Kelly wants some watermelon. We get the white guy to get watermelon. Look at you, this one. You know you want watermelon.
I don't really like watermelon that much.
What?
I know.
Have a Coca-Cola vanilla.
I'll eat a cold watermelon, but I don't love it.
And you from South Carolina?
And I'm from South Carolina. And I don't drink Kool-Aid, so. I know.
So the famous I Heart KL song. And the line, obviously. You guys saw this before. That's also the City Gallery. So if you're here, you might as well just go in the City Gallery. Check it out. I don't know what little dude's doing, but he ain't happy about being here. Popular! So this is Plaza Loyat, the IT Mecca, where you can buy laptops, cameras, hard drives. Actually, I bought all my laptops and a hard drive from here. I don't care about it. All right, so you guys see a bunch of different laptop brands. You see HP, you see Asus, you see Lenovo. All of these are 100% legit. The reason that there's so many here and they're so inexpensive here is because they're actually made here. A lot of these laptop brands actually are based here in Kuala Lumpur. This is where I get all my laptops and my hard drives. I am not an Apple guy, I'm a PC guy. So what I'm doing here now is I'm going to look for the components and price out the components to actually build a gaming PC and an editing PC. I usually just get Asus or Acer, a really high-end, or a Toshiba. I had a Toshiba a couple years ago, but this time I actually want to build my PC from the ground up, something I haven't done right now. The lady, she actually has an old MacBook Air, and we're going to see if she can find a battery for it. But everything here, you see here, this, over here is a Lenovo shop, Kaspersky, the anti-theft software is over there. You have a Seagate over here, HP and Asus over here, obviously Samsung. You have a BlackBerry store, which is still a thing apparently. And you have the ladies over here looking at the Asus store. And all of these are licensed and bonded, full warranty. I bought three laptops here in Kuala Lumpur, so if you're looking for a laptop, inexpensive, this is the best place to get it. So these are going to be the external hard drives, and they're pretty much the same price back home. For a terabyte, it's about $60, give or take. So you're not saving too much money. But coming on this side of the planet, it's, you know, it's a good price because that's comparable back home. But what I am looking at is getting myself a RAID drive. Basically, a RAID drive is, these are external drives that you can take out and replace with another hard drive. So since I'm starting to do 4K video and drone footage, I'm going to actually need more of those. So let me go over here. And this is, this is a computer geek's heaven. Like, this place is absolutely wonderful. But let me come over here and see if I can take a look at the processors and the memory. These are the displays. But looking for fans, gaming fans. So I'm probably gonna need something bigger than a 750, probably a 1,000. Let's see what the prices are looking at. Gaming towers with thermal links. This is gonna be the motherboard wall, and I like to stick with MSI, so I think I'll get an MSI card. Get an MSI card and get an MSI board. So these are the GTX 1070s. 1070s are up here. I don't know if I'm going to go Intel with the i7 or AMD, but I've never used the AMD. So I'm thinking about just going with an i7 and getting a really good cooler.
So we just priced out a full Intel i7 rig with the best gaming card, a solid state drive, a 2GB internal hard drive, 32 gigabytes of the fastest RAM that you can get. And it came up to $1,500 US. And that's not including the monitor. And that's a really good price for what you're getting. The biggest issue for me though is it's still running on Windows. I hate Windows. I don't know. It's tough.
I mean, and if you're into PCs or PC gaming, this place really is a paradise. Like, it has a little bit of everything: headphones, keyboards, hard drives, absolute chairs, everything, controllers. And let me turn y'all on to a really good brand. These are called Aways. These are really good headphones. This is actually what I use to work out now. This is $20. Really good. I mean, and honestly, for me, the sound quality is not as quite as high as Beats, but it's a really good brand. Check them out. Shopping for electronics is the equivalent to women shopping for clothes for guys. So when the guys shop for electronics, this is what the women do. They're standing away. No, I said shopping for electronics is the equivalent to women shopping for shoes.
Oh yeah.
So y'all just sit around and wait.
Good morning, guys. Welcome to the KL Bird Park. One of the main reasons I consistently come here is the world's largest free-flying aviary. So you come here when you arrive, and you can use cash or your debit card or credit card. It's 50 ringgit for adults and 41 ringgit for kids. So basically the same thing. And here's a quick illustration of the KL Bird Park. So it's broken up into different sections, and depending on what you want to see, you can come in. So usually you'll enter here, then you'll work your way through and around. You have the flamingos pond, and then you cut across to the hornbill. And I think they only have like two or three hornbills here, so they're really hard to see, so feel privileged. But remember, as you guys are gonna see, you're gonna see birds walking around like they live here. So it's not an enclosure, it's not like a zoo. You're literally in their house. So you have to be careful, pay attention. And if you're afraid of birds, you probably don't want to come to this. You have these gates as you come in to keep the birds, like just in case you come in, some birds are trying to get loose, they can't get out of these gates. And now you are in a free flying aviary, see? Birds, oh, let me do it. Ah, oh, there we go, better lighting. See? Look, we're birds. But then some you do have in enclosures that they don't want to let get loose. Like these guys.
That's so cool.
And this guy. Hey, guy. Beautiful peacock. Funny scenario, you come through here and you push, and then your whole way is blocked by a peacock. You just excuse me. That is massive. Look, you ain't going nowhere if he don't want you to go. And a lot of times, make sure you're careful, check the signs. Because clearly there's bird poop everywhere. And when it gets really humid, like it is right now, the way the grounds are just designed and are, they get a little bit slippery. But what are you doing? Excuse me. They're everywhere. Oh, no, he ain't happy. Let me go ahead and move away from him. And this is a great hornbill. Where is he? You can't really see him. That's my thing with the hornbills. You can't really see them. There he is up there.
Oh my god, that does not look like a real bird.
Come on, move.
Look at his head, it's like
made of
Lego.
He's massive. I'm trying to get him to fly. Oh, yep, I think he's gonna do it. Yeah. Look how big he is. And you can hear how big he is, how heavy he is. Alright, so look at these guys. Imagine grabbing a bite to eat and these guys are just hanging out. Everywhere. If you're scared of birds.
Hey, peacock.
Look, whoop.
They all know what time it
is. Yep. Food time. Look at these beautiful
peahens.
So the birds know what time food is, and obviously they know where it is. So if you see a bunch of birds going in one direction, it's likely they're going to go get the food from the caretakers. And that's exactly what's happening right now. Look at them walking with you.
Hey, buddy.
Look at this. This is the owl. These are the owls. So let me zoom in a little bit. Right here. And they can't fly free, obviously, because they'll eat pretty much half of the birds here because they're predators. You got two hidden in here. And these ones are the ones that come out for people to see. It's the Malay eagle owl, native to Malaysia, right there. I wish they can bring them out, but they gotta feed the other birds, but look at that. Here is where they do the eagle feedings. And these are all eagles. But they're smaller than the eagles that we know in the US, excuse me, birds. Here you are. Let's see if I can get in. There's one, two, you got two more over there. Everybody's on display. Yeah, it ain't nothing you can do. They don't want you to go by, you ain't going by. It ain't no getting around him. See, female? He's putting on, watch him vibrate his feathers like that. Putting on a show. For her. So the only birds that are really controlled and kept away from the other birds are the larger birds of prey because they eat the other birds. So they usually keep them in their own little enclosure, or at the very least, they'll keep them tethered to an open air enclosure like the owls, which will eat the other bird, the smaller birds. And they'll keep them, they'll have like a little chain on their leg, not a chain, like a little strap on their leg, and then only the handler can move them around here. Like any other place, some general rules, do not shout, don't pick the feathers, and not just don't pick the feathers, don't pick up feathers off the ground. Do not feed, do not mess with the birds, like throw stuff at them or poke them. Pull the bird's feathers, do not litter, don't pick the flowers. There's some vegetation that may give you an allergic reaction here. It's good for the birds, but bad for people. So you want to be careful and don't touch anything if you can help it. All the peacocks are, man, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Here's 2, 7, 8. Over here by the ostrich. So peacocks hang out with ostriches, apparently. So here are the ostriches. The last time I saw them was in South Africa. Oh, here they are. Absolutely. This video doesn't do justice to how big they are. They are massive birds. So as you guys can see, the guy right here with the whistle. Well, goddamn. They just follow him. I'm sorry, guys. It's like no matter how many times you see it, a bunch of birds flying at you is not. Got it.
That is awesome.
Mingo. Right here, you can see him. The pink one. I think I said it wrong earlier. Those are storks. And these are the flamingos. Stork, that guy. Flamingos here. See, yeah, these storks, they have a pink hue to them. Look at the feathers. Right there. And these guys. I didn't know that. This is the parrots and the lories feeding area. So this entire enclosure is all parrots from around the world. So blue for Amazon. They have a collectus. Oh, this guy here. They also eat chilies, which I did not know. These are chilies. They eat chilies. This is a cockatoo. Did he just?
I'm not kidding.
Hey.
Hello.
He talks. Hello. He doesn't like me.
Hello.
Because I sound like him.
Back of the waterfall.
So this is the booth, the photo booth, where you can take a picture with the birds. Don't trust that black one right there. He'll tap you on the head if you have bald hair. And it is 15 ringgit. Per person for two birds.
So quick tip, it's about 11 o'clock here and the temperature is starting to rise up. If you plan to go to the KL Bird Park, you have to come early in the morning because it's all enclosed in vegetation and netting. So the temperature is going to be significantly higher, a lot more humid than it normally is in KL, which is already hot and humid. So make sure you try to get here when they open at 9 o'clock. And then you'll be able to catch the 10:30 feeding. We got here about 10 to catch the 10:30 feeding. The crowds are really, really low, and this is the best time, especially when it comes to the temperature. If you have kids, you don't want to bring them out here when it's hot.
Yeah, they're called milky storks, not flamingos who haven't eaten the right food. They're milky storks.
Look at how they sit.
Is that how they sit?
Chilling.
Hey, look how they sit.
This is him chilling.
That's awesome. Damn, that is cool. Look at this. That's how they sit down.
Hey guys, I'm on back on the KLA Express. We just left the bird park, as you guys saw, and I'm heading back to Bangkok. I wanted to go ahead and end the video by thanking Kelly and Candace and Nia for hanging out for a couple days, and it was so good to run into people who share your cultural identity and your background and be able to have inside jokes, and we know the same music and movies and same you know, black stuff. It's rare and it's really fun, and I wish you guys all the best in your journeys. We're gonna keep in touch, and don't forget to check out the interview that I did with all three of them. I'm probably gonna post it up like the day after I post up this video. Also, quick tip, when you're going to the airport on the train, make sure you get off at the proper airport. There are two stops. The first one is Clear 1, second one is Clear 2. If you're flying budget airlines, you're going to be at 2. So make sure you understand which terminal you have to get off at. So yeah, it's been amazing once again to be in Kuala Lumpur. Absolutely love this city. Got a lot of clothes that I actually needed. And I'm looking forward to getting back to Bangkok, get back to work. So I will see you guys in the next video. Remember, lead the world better than you found it.